Okay, so let's get comfortable with mixers so that we can stare any mixer down no matter how big it is, okay? There are a lot of mixers out there, but once you pretty much know what the basic sections do, you'll be able to walk up to any mixer, you know, without breaking a sweat, okay? We're gonna be using this little Mackie mixer right here as it has a pretty easy layout and it's very typical in terms of the features that are available in pretty much almost any mixer out there. I know that many of you might be using a digital mixer and this is old school right here. Yeah, it is old school, but I've also found that learning the basics on an analog console like this really allows you to understand pretty much any board that's out there. No matter what console you have, certain things pretty much never change. You still need to know about setting up your levels, adding EQ, using aux sends for effects and also monitor mixers and other types of signal routing. Seeing all of this happen on an old school mixer like this really seems to kind of help you understand these concepts. And I've also brought along a mid-sized PreSonus digital mixer as well. I know these aren't the latest mixers. That's really not the point here. There's no way of knowing what mixers you're gonna be dealing with, but using these two here in this demonstration will kind of give us all the tools we need to understand how to get it around a mixer. This section will just be about the mechanics of how to use a mixer, what buttons to press, what knobs to turn, although there is another section later on simply called mixing, where we'll go through examples of how to mix a song from start to finish. This section is all about the tools available, and the mixing section later on is actually how to do it hands-on. Okay, so that being said, let's look at this mixer.